Hello and welcome to another edition of By The Way. Saurabh, today we are here to discuss a very integral and serious issue we've seen in the recent days, another terror attack wherein terrorists who had been, in fact sources say had been in India, in the vicinity of those areas for about 10 months, they had local supporters who provided them with arms and ammunition to carry out the terror attack. I think sort of this whole thing is very, very grave now. We've seen over a period of time, data and statistics show that our terror attacks in India have risen by almost about 42% in the last 3 years. The terror attacks have been almost about 13, approximately 13 to 14 in number, and these are only the major terror attacks that I'm talking about. And in all of this, what is coming in the forefront is Pakistan and its involvement in these things. Saurabh, what do you have to say to it? Is it time that we go back and give a serious message that something needs to be done? Yes.
Shukla, you know, over the last few days, I've been speaking to senior officials in South Block and who are handling this. And I can tell you that at the highest level, the government is mulling on some serious options now. Right. It's no longer going to be, certainly with Pakistan, it's not business as usual. But there's a realization that Pakistan is an irrational country, a country which cannot be handled in a normal, diplomatic or in a civilized manner. Right. When I say civilized, I'm not saying that you target the civilian population.
Right.
You will not go what Pakistan is doing, but there are other options that India has.
Right.
So just to spell it out, you know, one, obviously I strongly believe that you have to punish Pakistan where it hurts, because till the time we actually get this fear on in the minds of security establishment, those who have been supporting these terror
right.
groups, innocent Indians, our brave heart soldiers will continue to die. And for
right.
what? For what reason? So that's something which
Absolutely.
The government must do as soon as possible,
right.
because one surgical strike is not enough, and you
exactly.
have to deal with Pakistan.
Saurabh, in fact, surgical strike brings me to the next question to you. Actually, that is not enough. Is it that we need to do more on the army front in terms of surgical strikes so that, as you said, they get a befitting reply from us? The other aspect which I think or I want to ask you is that, is there something that we can do even more, more aggressively on the international forums? There's
yes,
UN,
yes.
there are other international
Absolutely.
Forums, which defense forums. Is India still trying to be a little nice and a little diplomatic?
You know, I'm glad you asked me that question.
Yeah.
And I've always felt that with Pakistan, somehow there is still a constituency in India
right.
Of peaceniks, you know, who think that, oh, Pakistan can be handled through diplomatic means. I think
right.
That's not going to happen. Pakistan
exactly.
will have to be handled. Diplomacy, yes, can mm-hmm. work, but it has to be coercive diplomacy. As you rightly
right.
said, that we need to use international forums like UN to get some of these officials, the Pakistani officials who are supporting these terrorists, on a sanctions regime.
Yes.
Unless we do that, Pakistan gets a message that it's business as usual.
Yeah.
The Indians will raise their noise,
right.
The media will raise their noise, and then it will be business like as usual. But that's not going to happen. The other thing, very crucial, and you know, bear in mind what the defense minister said yesterday, that Pakistan will have to pay for this, the way in manner in which families, kids,
exactly.
A pregnant
lady,
woman
absolutely.
was hit by a bullet. Can you imagine? This is the terrorism of the worst kind. And I think
also the fact, Saurabh,
India,
the fact
yeah.
that they got into so close to the residential quarters of army
no,
men.
That, that's certainly, see, that's I've always felt that, listen, we need to make sure that our own guard is never down. But obviously, sometimes it's physically, impossible. Although I still
right.
feel that modern technology allows us to make sure that you have the human security measures.
Right.
But use extensive technology to make sure these people don't enter.
Absolutely.
But having said that, till the time we actually instill that fear in the mind of the Pakistani military
right.
establishment that they cannot mess around with India, things will not change.
And, also,
I
yeah.
think strongly, this is election year. Don't discount anything. I don't discount Narendra Modi's possibility of springing something which is different, but it's high time the Prime
right.
Minister does that. Because enough is enough. No longer you can let innocent Indians bleed because of terrorism perpetrated from across the border.
And we need to move beyond the political angle. Parties need to absolutely. Understand that there are certain issues
where political games do not work.
There needs to be a cohesive process, a cohesive plan to handle this, because it is time to say no, we cannot take any more than this. There has to be a trust that needs to build up that the political, the government circles are doing something. Right. Our army men are doing a lot. And
absolutely.
And you saw, and I'm
telling you, and I was really perturbed by the way Mehbooba Mufti handled this whole case against the young army officer, Major Aditya.
Yes.
And I'm glad the Supreme Court intervened, has given that relief. But I can tell you, we should not have any politics over national security.
Absolutely.
Terrorism, something which every party in India should not pay lip service, but we must rally along with the government to fight it.
Right.
And when it comes to Pakistan, there should be one voice. Whether it's BJP, Congress, the left, they have
it's the Indian voice.
Indian voice, absolutely.
Forward.
Because Indians are suffering from terrorism. And we at News Mobile feel very strongly that the government must initiate some strong action against Pakistan, and especially against the terror ayatollahs, people like Hafiz Muhammad Saeed.
Yes.
Even though Pakistan has kind of branded finally Hafiz Muhammad Saeed as terrorist under UN pressure, but I will not, unless they act on the 26/11 perpetrators. Imagine, it's been so long and there's no justice for people who died in Mumbai.
Right.
So I think unless Pakistan acts, things will not change, and India must make sure that it, one of the traits of a leader is that you have to act and think like one.
Right.
And I think Narendra Modi and the government of India have to think and act like a leader. Make sure that you send the message down to Pakistani leadership and the military establishment that Indians will not take it for granted.
In fact, we would look forward to our viewers writing into us.
Yes.
What are certain measures that
you
think the government
how do we
do?
Discipline Pakistan? Absolutely.
And what is it that we can do?
Yeah.
And we're going to try and ensure that your comments and your voices are taken to the right people. Write into us, send in your comments, and keep watching News Mobile. Thank you.
Thank you.